Adding color can bring your old black and white photos to life, eliciting emotion from the viewer and allowing them to connect to the image in a way they wouldn't if it were just in grayscale. In this video, we're going to look at a simple and effective method to colorize your black and white photos in Photopea. We'll be using this image today. Check the description for the link to download it and follow along. The way this method works is by taking a series of solid color layers and using blending modes and masking to only affect the areas we want to color. We're going to need a separate color fill layer for each element of the photo we want to colorize. Let's start with her skin. Click on New Adjustment Layer and select Color Fill. I'll rename this new layer to Skin. Change the blending mode to Color and set the opacity to about 70%. Right now, the skin layer's mask is allowing everything through. We want to invert this mask and then use the brush to reveal the color in the areas where her skin is. To invert the mask, click on the mask's thumbnail and press Ctrl-I. Press B to activate the brush tool, set the foreground color to white, and start painting over her skin. The skin layer is coloring in where we paint. But we need to change the color to a more natural skin tone. You can try to select the color on your own, but it can be difficult to get a natural looking color, especially when you're just starting out learning this method. I'd like to use a reference image to borrow the colors from. This is best if you have another image of the same person, preferably in similar lighting. I don't have a color image of this woman, so we'll have to make do with this image. The link for this is also in the description. Just drag and drop the reference image onto the canvas to add it to our project and click Confirm. I'll use the Move tool to drag it down a bit out of the way. Double-click the skin layer thumbnail and click on the color swatch to set the color. Click on the reference image to sample her skin tone. Click around until you find a shade that you think looks best. And then hide the reference image layer. Then, select the skin layer's mask and start painting white to reveal the color anywhere her skin is. Lower the size of the brush to get into any hard-to-reach areas and try to fill in the outline first. Then, increase the size of the brush and fill in the center. Get right up against her hair and her eyes. Just paint right over her eyebrows and her eyelashes. If you go too far, just switch the foreground color to black and mask out any areas that shouldn't be skin tone. This whole process can go much faster if you can get a good selection of the area you want to color and just use the paint bucket tool to fill in the entire selection with white. But for this image, I'm just going to use the brush tool to unmask the color. From here, just keep painting and unmasking until all of her skin is colorized. Once you've colorized all of her skin, you can adjust the opacity to get a more natural look. The higher the opacity, the more cartoony or fake it will look, especially if you aren't using a natural skin tone like the one we got from our reference image. Next, let's color in her eyes. Zoom in on her face and create a new adjustment layer, Color Fill, and rename it to Eyes. Click on the mask to select it, and press Ctrl-I to invert it. Set the blending mode to Color, and leave the opacity to 100%. Use the brush tool to paint white to unmask the color over her iris. Do the same for the other iris. The red looks kinda cool, but unless she's a Terminator, it's kind of unrealistic. So double-click the fill color and click the color swatch. And I'll change it to a light blue. Then drop the opacity down until it feels natural to you. I think 100% would be fine, but I'm going to pull it down to about 80%. Next, let's move on to her lips. Add a new adjustment layer. Select color fill and rename the layer to Lips. Press Ctrl-I to invert the mask and reveal everything. Then set the blending mode to Overlay. When you're coloring images, I find that the color blending mode works great most of the time. But if it looks odd or unnatural, try using the Overlay mode or sometimes the Soft Light mode. Just experiment with these three blending modes as you go, and use whichever one looks the most natural to you. Set the opacity down to about 60%. Then, using white with the brush tool, with the lips mask selected, start painting to reveal the color. The lips are another element you may want to use the reference image to grab a natural color from. So, I'll unhide the reference image and take a sample from her lips. Hide the reference image layer and finish painting to unmask her lips. Paint everywhere on her lips, but make sure not to unmask her teeth. If the color looks a little odd, don't worry, we can adjust it after by taking another sample from the reference or just adjusting the opacity. You can see that the transition between her lips and skin looks a little unnatural. It's a sharp transition. What we can do is add some feather to the lips mask to soften that edge. With the mask selected, open up the Properties tab, and I'll set the feather to somewhere around 3.5 to 4. That gives us a little bit of blur right on the edge, softening that transition. If we zoom out, it's already starting to look a lot better. All we need to do now is color in her hair, her dress, and the background. Let's do the hair next. She has a lot of wispy hair here that will make it difficult to color in without getting a good selection. Check my video on removing the background from an image where I show how to make a good selection on fine strands of hair. For this example, we're just going to use the brush and get as close as we can. Add a new adjustment layer and choose Color Fill. Rename this layer to Hair. Select the Hair layer mask and press Ctrl-I to invert it. And let's take a sample from the reference image to get a good hair color. I want to grab a really light shade. Something like this. Hide the reference image. Set the blending mode of the hair layer to color. And set the opacity to 70%. Then, just continue painting white on the hair mask, revealing the color as you go. I'll try to get some of the bigger pieces of the wispy hair, but I'm not going to focus on that too much. Once her hair is unmasked, we can adjust the opacity to make it look a little more natural. I think about 55% looks good. Next, we'll color in her dress. New adjustment layer. Color fill. Rename it to dress. Press Ctrl-I to invert the mask. And set the blending mode to soft light, which will look a little more natural on the fabric of her dress. Set the opacity to 70%. For the dress, you can make it any color you'd like. I think blue would look right, but color it however you'd like to. Then, use the brush tool to paint white on the dress mask, starting with the edges. Make sure not to overlap any of the areas we've colored in already, and if you do, just switch the foreground color to black and mask out the areas where you went too far. I'll go ahead and fill in the rest of her dress. Once the dress is unmasked, we can adjust the opacity to a more natural level. If you used a different color than I did, you may need more or less opacity to get something that looks right, but I'll set it to around 40%. And finally, we just do the same thing one more time for the background. Add a new adjustment layer, color fill, and rename it to background. Set the blending mode to overlay, and the opacity to about 50%. I'll set the color to a light green, but use whatever color you think looks nice. We could use the same method by inverting the mask and using the brush to reveal the color on the background areas. But this time, we're going to do something different. We're going to take all the masks we created before and combine them into one new mask, which should leave just our background area showing. We'll only have to make a few edits to fix a few spots that don't mask correctly. First, let's delete the mask that was created with our background layer by right-clicking the mask and selecting Delete Raster Mask. Now, if you press Ctrl and click on one of the masks we've made previously, Photopea will make a selection of the mask. Then, we can hold down Shift and Ctrl and click on the next mask, and it will add to the selection we just made. Do this for all the masks we just created. Shift-Ctrl-Click to select each of them. Once you have all of the masks added to your selection, click on the background layer. Go up to the layer menu and select Raster Mask, Hide Selection. Now, if we Alt-click the background mask, you can see the actual mask and you can see the areas that we missed. The whites of her eyes, her teeth, and lots of other small areas are going to be affected by the background color. Just use the brush tool with the foreground set to black and fill in these areas. Alt-click the mask again to hide the mask. Now it looks pretty good, but there are a couple of areas where it looks wrong. If we zoom in on her arm, you can see some areas where the background color is bleeding into her arm. There may be some large areas that you missed while masking the rest of the image, and if there are, you'll need to use the brush tool to fill those in. But for stuff like this, where it just bleeds over a little bit, we can add some feather to the background mask. Open up the background mask's property panel and drag the feather property up until it smooths out those edges. If you go too far, the background color will start to blur into her skin, so you need to be subtle with the feather and keep it just high enough to slightly blur that hard line. Okay, we're almost finished. At this point, we can select all of the color layers by selecting the background layer and shift-clicking the skin layer, then add them all to a folder by clicking the new folder icon. I'll rename the folder to Color, and we can toggle the visibility of the folder to see the before and after. Last, we're going to add one more adjustment layer inside of the Color folder. Go to New Adjustment Layer and select Curves. Add 3 points evenly up the grid. Drag the first point down just a little to strengthen the shadows a bit. Do the same with the second point. Bring it down just enough to give a little more contrast. And do the same with the third point, pulling it down until it looks a little more natural. Be careful because you can easily go too far and make the image look washed out. Once you adjust the curves layer and everything looks natural, go ahead and A/B your image and see the progress you made. That's all there is to it. Nothing about this process is very difficult, but it can be time-consuming to get your masks edited correctly and to select colors that make the image look realistic. Using this technique, you can easily transform any black and white photo to color if you put the effort in to get everything looking nice. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.